Actually, Girlfriend in a School, where I am working now as a principal, it's one of the pioneer institutions in Dubai. Almost having 38 years completed now, it has ended 39th year of service in the field of education. And it's one of the prime institution, I will say, because the quality of education is superb. I'm very happy to join here, because once I joined, I could see that, you know, the team, the teachers as well as students, they are really with very high potential. Only we have, you know, some other restrictions regarding infrastructure, so we are running in two shifts. That's the only concern. Otherwise, we are graded close to good by KHDA, but still, it's a natural phenomenon. So when every year the level of expectation is a little bit raised, okay, we will be preparing ourselves for something, and later when they inspect, they may find something over there. So again, our dream of becoming a good school, and it's yet to materialize, but we are very much made up of mind for doing it by the next inspection cycle. Actually, when we speak of change, you know, much of the things are in place now. Only, you know, we want refinement, we want perfection in these areas. Teaching learning, of course, happens to be one major area. Then SEN care, special education needs students care, which includes even GNT students, okay, taking care of them and providing or meeting their needs. That is another challenge we have. And then, of course, the classroom activities, teaching learning part, you know, it has to be more on an activity based. If we are actually doing it, but still the expectation was much more. And, you know, of course, CBSE curriculum, it has its own limitations too. I'm not speaking bad about it, but in Indian curriculums all generally have this one, the content load is too much. Whereas in British curriculum schools, you know, it's gone a skill based. So what we are trying to do is to merge these two approaches and then deliver the students the skill based approach, the contents. So we are conducting international assessments and all every year. Internal assessment also we have done. International assessment include ASSERT and CAT4 and all. From there we get a yearly feedback on where do our students stand, in what area they are strong and what area they are weaker. So we try to find out these weaker areas solution. We will develop strategies and we will incorporate in the system, or maybe we will add them in as a part of the curriculum. If at all some skills are missing or found weak, that will be added to the curriculum, and a program will be made for, you know, 10 months schedule, what particular skill will be trained on which particular month and that grade. And this way we will revisit, we will see whether there is an improvement and all, and this is the way we are proceeding now forward. So we are therefore very confident that by next visit we will be getting a good. Of course, I think one major issue is this content based curriculum. I mean, large amount of things to be marked up. They need to learn this by heart, but its application side is not that stressed. It is done in Gulf, okay, especially in Dubai it is done. But at the same time, comparing with these students in India, so they are not exposed to this. Some schools are there, outstanding schools are there, they are doing, they are catering to this requirement, but others are not there. So one is this reducing the content area and making it more a skill-based education, so that our children are really empowered to lead a life. Now mainly the children are assessed. Earlier there was a CCA system, now that is also scrapped off. The children are assessed again on a 3-hour based assessment based, okay, whether they are eligible for a promotion. Studying for almost 10 months and then assessing someone in 3 hours to decide their fate, it has got its own limitation. But still the system remains there, and then we need to do something on this area. Like internal assessment was there in place due to CCE system and all earlier. But if something else, you know, keeping away all the possibilities of issues that may pop in implementation of the CCE or implementation of internal assessment, those areas also to be given some due weightage, I feel. That is one thing. From Indian background, if a teacher comes, the main issue here will be a conversion into lecture method, from lecture method to activity-oriented method, where the teacher is only a facilitator and not a a super talker. In that case, you know, the teachers initially, when we are recruiting from India, we find that they find it difficult to master the task of limiting their talk to 8 to 10 minutes in a period, and then planning different strategy, different task and all, based on the caliber of the students, and then allocating them, taking them through these tasks and constructing knowledge, how they can be, and then establishing knowledge. In our school, we have, for every lesson, there should be a lesson objective and a success criteria to be formulated by the teacher in well in advance. Oh, what does it mean? Means at the end of this session, okay, as per the objective set, what the children will be able to demonstrate to do after imbibing that knowledge that the teacher foresee in advance. And then here in this part of the world, we have to cater to the different levels of students. It's not single delivery. Like, there are students who are average, above average, below average, maybe gifted and talented, and special needs students. So one teacher has to cater to all these five groups within the same time. So it's a great challenge for the teacher, but some teachers are doing it, you know, wonderfully well. Actually, now it is like almost a triangulation: the child, the school, and the parent. If all these three things work together, move together, only we can expect a progress in the life of the child, in the learning of the child. To parents, what I would suggest is, okay, they must be an essential part of the studies. Whatever assignment or areas have been allocated for home assignments, they should be knowing what is done by my child, what has been done in the classroom, how this is going to be supportive. School will naturally have orientation sessions and all for parents, so don't miss any of these sessions, because whenever anything is there, for example, I spoke about life skill education to be introduced. Now, parents should know, first of all, what is the importance of life skill education there. So one orientation session is compulsory for them. And then only when we implement it, it will have its real fruits. Otherwise, two wheels around, like the teacher and the child alone is trying, we may not achieve success. Similarly, parents know, see, the gadgets are in full use now. Even schools, you know, even our school has a BYOD policy. They bring tabs and they are exposed to these contents. Now we have actually BYOD policy where some filtering software is installed in the system, so they cannot access it in here. But students are highly brilliant in this area. I often doubt that they have got something like an IT intelligence too, because people at my age find it very difficult to master a device. Okay, it takes some time, whereas a grade 2 child or grade 1 child is very easily handling those things with the latest or almost its full options. So that way, when they are far advanced, they have to always keep a close monitoring on what they do on this device. Okay, most often what happens, they will be under the impression that my child is studying and there is nothing to be taken care of. Leaving them for granted, then it will be possibly having a backlash. So that issues we have to address too.